Vivian, I'm the one who says they should be doing more work around the house. You're the one who's too easy on them.
Oh, really? Does this sound familiar?
Daddy, I need $300.
Colvin, you are not going to MacArthur Park tonight. In fact, none of you are going to MacArthur Park tonight.
Wait a minute.
Boy, do not test me.
Yes, ma'am.
Big wheel keep on turning. Raspberry keeps on burning.
Wow, she is the talented actress best known for her role as the original Aunt Viv on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Now she's joining us to talk about the emotional reunion and her brand new series. Welcome, Janet Hubert. Janet, we are so excited to have you this morning. You actually posted on Instagram that this interview with us right now is your very first since the reunion. You said no to all the others, but something incredible happened to you that you want to talk about. Janet, what happened? Because we're dying to know.
I've done first of all, good morning.
Good morning.
I've done some interviews via telephone, but nothing in person. I came home and started to get a little bit nervous about the whole Red Table takeover. And when I saw it, and when I saw what Will did, I was absolutely so moved that I couldn't watch it. I ended up turning it off and running away from the computer, because generally I don't show the kind of vulnerability, but to see him say what he said about his own pain, his own, what he was going through and what I was going through at the same time, we were going through the same thing, but at different times. So I was compelled to finally step on camera and step back in front of the camera to do an interview, which it's time. It was time.
We are so happy that you chose to be with us this morning. You know, you've been through a lot. I mean, clearly, you're what you've been through with the show, what you've been through in your life. We're actually going to show a clip of you and Will Smith talking about the reunion and talking about everything that happened. So let's take a look at that, and then I want to ask you some questions.
Sure.
You know, words can kill.
Mm-hmm.
But I lost everything. Reputation. Everything. Everything. And I understand you were able to move forward, but you know those words, calling a black woman difficult mm-hmm. in Hollywood is the kiss of death.
Mm-hmm. So now that the dust is all settled, are you able to fully accept his apology?
Absolutely.
That's great.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because all I ever wanted back was my reputation.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I've been asking for 27 years. And it wasn't so much, you know, Will's words were, it started the initial war of 27 years later. But when he said, I thought you hated me.
Mm-hmm.
So that, and Donald Trump and this administration and COVID and all of the losses that we've had in this world, it's time for the hate to stop.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't find out about the reunion invite until a day before I was to fly out and go to the reunion. They had been trying to get in touch with me to no avail. So when I found out and asked whose idea it was, and they said it was Will's, I had to go.
Yeah.
Because I wanted this to be over, mm-hmm. desperately wanted this to be over. I said I wasn't going to serve another 27-year life sentence.
It's a great point.
Can I ask her a question?
Sure, absolutely.
I'm not sure if you can hear me, but I was so touched when I saw it I saw this relief mm-hmm. come over you, this wave of yeah. relief. And then you reached out to hug him, mm-hmm. which looked to me like he so desperately needed that, but so did you.
And you know, I want to tag team on that question. I wanted to ask you, because it seemed like you'd been through a lot of darkness. Do you feel lighter now that this weight is lifted off your shoulders?
It's starting to.
Okay.
You can't give me back 27 years mm-hmm. of what was taken away, because understand the time when my son was a baby was taken away from me. That all that time of my late 30s, all of my 40s, all of my 50s, half of my 60s, with being labeled a difficult bitch, that's hard to let go. It's starting. Mm-hmm. It's starting with the outpouring of love and support from people and working on my own project, you know, my children's project, making my own way. I've had to make my own way because there was no one to save me. There was no one to reach out to. There was no Oprah. There was no Ayanna. There was no Dr. Phil that could do this. Only Will could do this. And it was always only between he and I. So yes, we've been communicating back and forth. text messaging, and it feels really good. And when I did hug him, I hugged him, and he hugged me back for real, because we both needed it so desperately from each other. So I'm not used to showing that kind of vulnerability unless I'm acting, you know, in a role, because people have been so cruel.
Right.
So, yeah, it feels good. It's starting to really feel good.
Is there a silver lining in this? Because now there's you've been getting a lot of attention because of this. Is there a silver lining that maybe you're getting more attention, and could we possibly be seeing you in more TV shows or movies or on Broadway? Could that translate into more possible opportunities?
You know, I'm going to be 65 in January. My time of dancing and singing and carrying on like that is done. I'm doing something now with JG and the BC Kids. I'm also working on something else that I can't talk about right now. But maybe.
I gotta say, you might be 65, but you are gorgeous.
Yes,
and 65 is like the new 40. There's plenty of time for you to do. I can't wait to see what you're going to do. You've handled this with such grace. Like, I cannot wait to see what the strength of a woman like you can do.
Thank you. And we're looking for distribution for JG and the BC Kids. So if you're looking for something really different and something wonderful and something exciting, please contact me. Reach out.
That's a great point, because it's a very smart, smart series that I love, and I was reading all about it. You know, it's interesting because we were talking about strong women, and you never know who's watching, you know, and you never know who you're influencing. And you clearly have influenced so many women all over the world in the last week, but also a little young girl who had watched you. Viola Davis actually posted this week. I want you to take a quick look at how adorable this is. Isn't that amazing? Viola captioned it. Isn't that adorable? And she captioned the viral video of you and your ballerina mini-me. She said, saying, we influence more than we know. And I think that is so important, that we're all watching you. We all acknowledge you. We all see you. And we're all really, really proud of you.
I appreciate that. And I appreciate the love and the incredible outpouring. I had no idea that this character was so beloved. I had no idea that people were looking for healing. It was a healing. It felt like God. It felt like a laying on of hands for me and for Will to come together. And I'm so proud of him for doing it and for reaching out to me. I had to say yes, because I could not say no. I could not say no. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much to the entire world. Who knew? And all those little girls who were inspired by my 36-year-old dance.
You're so fantastic, Janet. We just love you. You, and by the way, when you get your children's book on the air and when you get your series on the air, we want you to come back and talk all about it.
I'd love to.
Because we'd love to see it. So everybody out there, stay tuned to see JG and the BC Kids. We're waiting on that. Janet, we love you. Thank you for sharing with us.
Thank you
for your vulnerability. And we'll be right back after this. We love you, Janet.
Bye-bye. Love
Bye.
You, too.
Bye.
Ciao.